Good morning children. This video we are going to see about Indian drainage system part 3 lesson 1 grade 10 geography India location and relief and drainage. While we are talking about the Indian drainage system, it is divided into two: Himalayan rivers and peninsula rivers. Himalayan rivers, the Indus river system, the Ganga river system, the Brahmaputra river system are called the Himalayan rivers. Indus river, see children, this is Indus river. Indus river is one of the largest rivers of the world. It enters with the Arabian Sea. The Ganga river system, see here it is the Ganga river system. The Ganga river system is the largest drainage system of India. The Ganga plain is the most densely populated place of India. The Brahmaputra river system, see this is Brahmaputra river system. The river Brahmaputra originates from the Kailash range, joins with Ganga in Bangladesh and empties in Bay of Bengal. Next group of rivers, peninsula rivers. Peninsula rivers are divided into east flowing rivers and west flowing rivers. River Maganadi. River Maganadi originates near Chhattisgarh and flows through Odisha. Its length is 851 km. The Maganadi empties its water in Bay of Bengal. Next, Godavari. See here, Godavari. It is also called Ruduganga. It flows through the states of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh before joining Bay of Bengal. River Krishna. River Krishna originates from a spring in the Western Ghats of Maharashtra. It flows through the Andhra Pradesh and join Bay of Bengal. River Kaveri. River Kaveri originates at Talakaveri, Kudagu Hills of Karnataka. Its length is 800 km. At last, it empties into the Bay of Bengal at Pumbagar. While talking the west flowing rivers, Narmada and Tapti. Narmada. It is the longest among the west flowing rivers of peninsular India. Tapti. The Tapti is one of the major rivers of peninsular India with the length of about 724 km. It outfalls into the Arabian Sea through Gulf of Cambay. Let us discuss about the characteristics of Himalayan rivers and South Indian rivers. Himalayan rivers are originated from Himalayas. Can you give me a point about South Indian rivers? Yes, South Indian rivers are originated in Western Ghats. They are long and wide. South Indian rivers are short and narrow. They are perennial in nature. They are non-perennial in nature. Himalayan rivers are unsuitable for hydropower generation. South Indian rivers are suitable for hydropower generation. Middle and lower courses are navigable. South Indian rivers not useful for navigation. So by this you can write that characteristics of Himalayan rivers and characteristics of South Indian rivers. This is the third part. We are completed the first lesson. Let us start the next lesson next week. Thanks for watching.